Greetings and welcome to the 2020 University of Washington Physics Department graduation ceremony. I am Lawrence Yaffe, Department Chair, and I would like to congratulate our record-setting class of over 200 Bachelors of Science recipients, together with several dozen PhD and professional master's awardees. Physics is a fascinating and challenging subject. Physics education involves a unique mix of study and practice of experimental techniques and instrumentation, mathematical analysis and calculation, observation and modeling, and most importantly, careful reasoning from fundamental principles. I hope that all of you have experienced some of the joy, as I have, when one appreciates for the first time how some strange and unexpected phenomena can be understood as arising from the basic building blocks of modern physics. And that this joy stays with you as the memory of endless homework, all-night study sessions, and final exams begins to fade. Graduation marks a time of transition, a celebration and acknowledgement of your accomplishments, a gateway to new opportunities, endeavors, and careers, perhaps a change of lifestyle or locale. However your paths unfold, you will always remain part of our family of UW physics alumni. I am proud of the class of 2020. I regret that this year we cannot confer degrees in person. On behalf of the Department of Physics, I applaud all our graduates and sincerely wish you all the best.
Welcome and congratulations to our 2020 graduates and your family and friends. I am Professor Marjorie Olmsted. I'm the Associate Chair for Undergraduate Affairs and the Undergraduate Faculty Advisor. I wish this event could be in person so that I could have a chance to say goodbye with a handshake or a hug, and also to be introduced to the people who have supported our graduates as they have made this incredible achievement. You are all invited back to next year's celebration, so we can actually shake your hand in person. But meanwhile, thanks and congratulations. Now, while we are in this period of uncertainty and disruption, I would like to urge you to reflect on the past 2 months, that they are but a small part of the many years and experiences that have led to this point. And I also encourage you, as you move forward, especially through these next few months, to stay in touch, whether it's by Zoom or Skype or actually writing a letter. It's important that we all stay connected. And stay in touch not only with me and Margot and Paola, but also more importantly with each other. You are over 2% of the students graduating this year in the United States with a bachelor's degree in physics, and you will be each other's network for years to come. I'd like to do a shout out to our remarkable class. You're the largest graduating class in the history of our department and likely the largest in US history. Right now we have 211 students scheduled to finish up our Bachelor of Science degree between autumn 2019 and this coming summer. Over a quarter of our class identifies as female, making this likely the largest number of women ever to graduate from a single department as well. We've graduated the largest class in the country for most of the past decade. 2 years ago, the most recent year for which we have national data, there were only four universities, including us, who graduated more than 100 students. Our graduates are a diverse group who have taken multiple pathways to their degree. Our graduates range in age from 18 to 37. They started at University of Washington anywhere from 1.5 years ago to 15 years ago. Many transferred to UW after starting at community college or another four-year school. Many have taken time off to deal with personal or health issues. And to those of you who ran into some snags, took some time off, and figured it out and came back, I would like to do a special shout out to you. I know it wasn't easy, and congratulations. I am so delighted and proud that you are here ready to graduate. I'd like also to give a special shout out to the 51 graduates who are the first in their families to graduate from college, and especially to their families for supporting them in this exciting and what is often a challenging endeavor. We have graduates who grew up within walking distance of the University of Washington, and others who grew up completely on the other side of the globe. Over 80% of our students have pursued research while here at the university that ranges from studying single atoms that are suspended by laser beams in the middle of a vacuum chamber to how galaxies form, from how sound levels impact the way an emergency room works to designing a rotating detonation engine for rocket propulsion. Physics students have been leaders on UW's Formula SAE team or on the robotics team, and they've been undergraduate research ambassadors. They have served their peers as teaching assistants and as hosts orienting new international students. They've been active in the Society of Physics Students, and many have won national awards. While our most common double majors are math and astronomy, we also have students whose second degree is in dance or microbiology or the comparative history of ideas. What our diverse group of graduates has in common is an ability to look at the physical world and pose questions that help them understand what is happening. They've learned how to express that understanding in both words and equations, and how to take and analyze data that will lead to informed decisions. They can think analytically and critically. 10 years from now, very few of you will remember the details of where the factors of 4 pi go in any particular equation. But you will remember how to approach a complex problem, how to break it into parts, and how to get help from experts. Graduates, as you go forth armed with your physics degree, we are depending on you to tackle your share of the challenges that face us as a society. As our world faces difficult times, we're making and basing decisions on well-analyzed evidence can and will save lives. We are depending on people like you to provide that key analysis. Keep in touch. We want you as part of our network. I would also like to take this opportunity to thank those of you who have supported our graduates as they have transitioned from curious children to knowledgeable adults. From knowing when to step in and help, to knowing when to sit back and watch, which is often harder. Thank you for being there. We'll shortly have a time to praise and laud our students, but now I would like to invite our students to take a moment and applaud and thank your supporters. And not just your family, don't forget to drop an email to Margot or Paola or Susan and your favorite professors or TAs and let them know as well. Thank you for joining us today. What follows will be contributions from each of our graduates who chose to participate, showing you a little bit about them and their plans. I am proud and honored to have been your faculty advisor, and for many of you to have had the privilege to teach you in the classroom. It's been a real joy watching you mature and learn and make that transition from beginning student to physicist. Welcome to the rank of physicist, and congratulations as you go forward. Thank you.
Hello, UW class of 2020. We did it. We've learned enough classical, quantum, and statistical, and all the other mechanics to be called physicists. If you don't know me, I'm Chris Moore, and I was the SPS president last year. It's humbling for me to think of the many ways that our graduating class is going to affect the world that is clearly in desperate need of problem solvers like us. For those going into graduate programs and teaching, just remember the grad students that inspired and helped you along the way, and be sure to carry that torch wherever you go. Thank you to the grad students that helped make our education possible with so many students. Wherever any of you end up, I know that you'll contribute great perspective, and I hope that you can share some of the passion for learning, the secrets of the world with the people that you meet along the way. And on that note, I have to thank Professor Olmsted for always giving correct, evidence-based advice for our career paths and for keeping a passion for physics lit in so many people. Before I came to UW, I was stationed in small town Kodiak, Alaska, and decided to call UW Physics Advising to see if it was the right place for me to study. After introducing myself and talking to Margot for no longer than 1 minute, she was already telling me stories about living and working in Kodiak, Alaska herself. Margot, your genuineness and experience removed so much potential stress from our lives. Thank you for your wonderful sense of humor and always making time to be knowledgeable on the issues that we faced. I'm gonna miss the exercise of walking uphill to get to just about anywhere else on campus. I'm also going to miss balancing catching up with people that you run into on the way to class with getting to those classes on time. The basement, the fourth floor, and the SPS room felt like these small bustling microcosms that I'm really gonna miss being a part of. The other members of the SPS, the League of Astronomers, and the Women in Physics all played a role in bringing people together and improving the future lives of undergraduates, so thank you to everyone that helped. I'd like to personally thank Professor Kaimei Fu and all the students I've worked with in her lab for their genuine curiosity they bring to their research and to the group meetings. You've all taught me much more than just physics, but you also taught me a ton of physics, so thank you for that too. As we move to a new chapter in our lives, I hope that you can look back with fondness, remembering the amazing things that we've learned and the amazing community of curious and friendly people that we met along the way. And I hope that you look forward with hope for equality, a healthy planet, and the entropic expansion of our collective volume of knowledge.
Hello everyone, congratulations to all the graduating students of UW Physics Department 2020, and my condolences to George Floyd's family and all the people out there who have experienced the recent tragedy and have felt the pain of injustice being done. There's a room on the southeast of the fourth floor of the physics building. It's a conference room that I would spend most of my mornings there with people like Landon Bevier, Chris Moore, Scott Bobson to study, to chat, to do homework, and sometimes on the weekends play Dungeons & Dragons. There's a lot of great memories in that room, but in particular, there's one thing that is really, really valuable to me, and it's a Pictus plant by the window. At first, when I came to UW, that plant was dying, so I started watering it as a part of my routine every day. I started taking care of it, and it started growing. I put pins on the wall and guided it all over the room and started taking over the whole place. It's really valuable because it's a metaphor for myself. At first, when I came to UW, I found myself in this pool of chaos that academia is, and I'm really glad that I found my way to the physics department and it became a home to me really quick. Like that plant, I started growing in the physics department. I started gaining new skills and knowledge and making connections. Thanking to Professor Blinoff for letting me be part of his research group for quantum computation by ion trapping. Thanking Professor Olmsted and Detweiler for giving me a reason to love physics. It is truly lovable. And my advisors, of course. Thanking Alexis Hall, Professor Schaefer for giving me job opportunities and helping me gain teaching skills. But one person to thank the most, I mean, I love my advisors, Catherine, Paula, but one person to thank the most is Margot Nims, with whom this would not be possible. Margot, you're amazing, you're a wonderful person, and you're so lovable. you were like a second mother to me. Thank you so much. This department is so lucky to have you, and we are so lucky to have you. This department was one of the best experiences that I've had, and I'm so glad to be part of it. And I'm so glad that I became a student there to help me gain all the knowledge and gain all the skills. Of course, I'm not going to graduate school in physics, I'm going to philosophy, but I owe every single bit of it to the physics department and all the skills that I gained there, from all the fun that I had with playing games with my friends, to the Launchbox seminars of the Society of Physics Students, being part of the major committee, and all the last minute tutorial homeworks that we had to turn in. It was a journey. I'm both glad and sad that it's come to an end. and I'm really, really grateful for it. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Hello, my name is Anna Roche, and I'm happy to be a member of the graduating class of 2020. The physics department had a great impact on my undergraduate years, and I could not be more thankful for the time I have spent in our nice little southwest corner of campus. During my freshman year orientation, the need to make UW feel smaller was brought up several times. I always assumed I would accomplish this by joining some of the many clubs at UW, but this happened effortlessly by simply declaring physics as my major. I eventually met many of my closest friends through this department, and I could not feel more at home than on the fourth floor of PAB or in the machine shop grabbing a cup of the most affordable coffee in all of Seattle. There are memories from the past 4 years that will stick with me forever. The relief of finishing the physics intro series, the one time the equation I needed was actually on my note sheet, and how surprisingly terrible the trees outside H-Bar smell each spring. The physics department was a perfect blend, bringing me a friendly and comfortable environment while offering access to all the amazing research a large school has to offer. I cannot thank my professors, advisors, and fellow students enough. All the best to the class of 2020.
University of Washington, Department of Physics, graduating class of 2020. Class of 2020, by the numbers. Departmental Award winners. Physics honors. Introducing the Physics Doctor of Philosophy graduates. Shaylit Chang, PhD in Physics. Shaylit Chang specialized in physics education research. He is keen to discover students' difficulties in understanding physics and help them to learn physics better. He would like to express his gratitude for the support from the faculty and fellow graduate students whom he had worked with all these years. He appreciates their guidance and have learned a lot from them. He will continue to work hard in his future endeavors. Lisa M. Goodhue, PhD in Physics. As an undergraduate at Seattle Pacific University, Lisa decided to major in physics and minor in studio art, in order to gain a solid foundation for the career in architecture she planned to pursue after graduation. After a few physics classes, she realized how much she enjoyed thinking about physics and working with classmates to solve problems. After a summer REU in physics education research and a year as a learning assistant, Lisa decided to pursue a PhD in physics education research, PER. Lisa found a home with the University of Washington's PER group in the fall of 2015, and was awarded an NSF Graduate Research Fellowship to support her work with Dr. Paula Heron and collaborators, in spring 2016. Lisa is incredibly grateful for Paula's support, advice, and flexibility throughout her graduate school career, and for the time and mentorship given by many members of the Physics Education Group. She looks forward to collaborating with Paula and the UW PEG after graduation. Lisa would also like to thank Stamatis Vokos, Rachel Scher, and most especially, Amy Robertson for their continued support, care, and mentorship, along with family and friends, who have helped to make the graduate school journey joyful. Elena Green, PhD in Physics. In theoretical physics, there are partial differential equations, and for those, we have Green's functions to help us find the solution. In experimental atomic physics, we have unilluminated atoms and stationary electrons. To solve this problem, we have our own Green's function, Elena Green. Elena has been a kernel for the progress of the Mixtures Project, by building lasers and electronics. In the spirit of her alma mater Lewis and Clark College, Elena explores uncharted territory to understand the formation of ultra-cold molecules. In addition to having the spirit of a pioneer, Elena is compassionate, adaptable, accepting, devoted, and imaginative, And for that, we were very lucky to have her. Outside of the lab, Elena might be found biking to or from the lab, or gardening to prepare food that she will take into the lab. Let me remind the reader that it's the age of the Pisces, therefore we anticipate great things from Elena.
William M. Holden, PhD in Physics. William Holden started in the Seidler Group autumn 2015, where he immediately began work on extending the laboratory X-ray spectroscopy techniques to X-rays of lower energy. His work culminated in the world's first laboratory-based, high-resolution spectrometer capable of measuring sulfur and phosphorus X-ray emission spectra at count rates and resolution comparable to synchrotron performance. He continued development and improvement of the low-energy spectrometer and utilized it to complete novel studies of sulfur and phosphorus-containing samples, such as a recent study of INP quantum dots. After graduating, William will be working with EasyXAFS LLC, a local startup company, created to increase access to laboratory X-ray spectroscopy techniques through the commercialization of the technology. William would like to thank his wife, Izumi, for her support and encouragement, as well as his labmates Evan, Alex, Ryan, Oliver, and John, and his advisor Jerry.
Natalie Klucko, PhD in Physics. Natalie has spent recent years pursuing the basics questions: is a controllable quantum system sufficient to efficiently stimulate the subatomic world? And if so, how do we make this vision a reality? For many intellectually inspiring interactions, Natalie thanks her advisor, Martin Savage, the Institute for Nuclear Theory, and the community of physicists at the University of Washington. In the fall, Natalie is excited to join the Institute for Quantum Information and Matter as a Burke Fellow at the California Institute of Technology. Katie McAlpine, PhD in Physics. Katie McAlpine is experienced in optics and quantum sciences. Katie joined Subhadeep Gupta Lab after moving to rainy Seattle from sunny Florida. Before moving to Seattle, she also studied physics at New College of Florida, a school known for narrative evaluations and barefoot students. While Katie has since used her impressive collection of sweaters and beanies to blend in with the locals, her Floridian upbringing remains salient, as her radiant personality brought sunshine to the physics lab. Katie graduated from the University of Washington's Physics PhD program in autumn 2019, where she did theoretical and experimental work in the subfield of atom interferometry. At UW, Katie helped found a student organization called Physicists for Inclusion and Equity, PIE, focusing on making the physics department a welcoming space for all. Rachel Osofsky, PhD in Physics. Rachel graduated working on precision particle physics experiment at Fermi National Accelerator Laboratory. Her expertise was in nuclear magnetic resonance measurement techniques, making the magnetic field of a superconducting magnet homogeneous, and building and testing magnetometers. She gained experience in data acquisition, software development, and precision data analysis. Focused, self-motivated, critical thinker, Rachel has a passion for science outreach and leadership experience within a large collaboration. Adam Ritchie Halford, PhD in Physics. Adam studied the BCS-BEC crossover and infinite neutron matter using quantum Monte Carlo simulations on the world's largest supercomputers. He feels tremendously fortunate to have worked alongside brilliant and caring people, both in his cohort and in the faculty and staff. He is starting a postdoctoral position at the Nexus of Machine Learning and Neuroimaging at the UWE Science Institute. Adam thanks his advisor, Aurel Bulgatz, for his guidance and patience, his collaborators Joaquin Drut, Gabriel Wawowski, Jeremy Holt, and Kenny Roche for sharing their own physical intuition, his supervisory committee for their hard work in making his dissertation and defense better, and his friends and family for their love, support, and humor over many years of study. Michael P. Ross, PhD in Physics. Michael Ross received his PhD with the EITWASH group, working on inertial rotation sensors for the LIGO Gravitational Wave Observatories and torsion balance tests of gravity. His dissertation work has allowed the LIGO observatories to operate during high winds, increasing the number of detected gravitational waves. He has also worked on novel calibration techniques for LIGO, rotational seismology, low-frequency gravitational wave detection, and cryogenic tests of the equivalence principle. Jesse Stryker, Doctor of Philosophy in Physics Quantum Field Theory. Jesse has always been fascinated with learning about the underlying structure of matter and energy. He excelled as a physics major at Arizona State University, which compelled him to further deepen his understanding of nature as a graduate student. At the UW, he has enjoyed the ability to use quantum mechanics daily, as a tool for interpreting the microscopic behavior of particles, as well as for the future of computation. Next fall, he will start as a postdoctoral research associate at the University of Maryland, working at the interface of nuclear physics and quantum information. Jesse thanks David Kaplan and Martin Savage for instilling in him a high research standard to strive for, and for encouraging him to pursue projects that nurtured both his imagination and his persistence in finding intuitive physical interpretations, Dorota G., Natalie K., and Michael W., for providing him with key stabilizing interactions, and his family and friends, for their role in making his life balanced. Kyle J. Aitken, Andrew Baumgartner, Emily Clark, Daniel Dilevsky, Charles S. Fessler, John G. Lee, Jennifer F. Lillian, Yingting Lin, Xiaoyu Lin Ping, David Summer, Chunsheng Dan, Nathan Wilson, Bert Zhu, Wen Jinzhou. Introducing the Physics Master of Science graduates: Michael A. Asubina, Casey Ferris, Michael Greiner, Aziz A. Khan, Chris Knutson, Thomas Eric Loop, Christopher Michael Brovincier.
Introducing the Physics Bachelor of Science graduates: Austin Alf,
Riley Michael Albright,
Nakar Arora,
Yifei Bai,
Landon Bevier, Neil Bhatia, Pasha Bullock, Jeffrey Kapoman Jr., Sonia Del Casal,
Stefana Chustea,
Johan Petru Constantine,
Jax Jefferson Demir, Connor Deerwester, Kurt Delagarde, Madison Renee Durand.
Wesley Coiffier.
Callum Farrell. Alex F. Foster. Frank Fu.
Ileana Lyon Aguez.
David Hales. Suyishui Han.
Marquise Deshaun Harris. Timothy Wolfgang Harris. Ali Hassanzadeh. Tom Hempel. Noah C. Hoppus. Ian Douglas Hogan. Julia B. Jansen.
Anthony Jew. Emily Sage Joseph. Sophia Young. Maxim Karenbach. Claire Komori. Leah Kong.
Gautam Nainan Kovur.
Brian Kula.
Nicholas Lightman Naimi.
Ryan Mark Luttrell.
Leon Z. Liu. Alexandra Lockwood.
Claire Johanna Old Luhouse.
Sora Ma. Timothy Matthew.
Olivia McGoldrick.
Megan M. Miyasaki.
Chris Moore. Tina Khan Nguyen.
Talia Quilliota.
Devin Paulus. Alexandria Kathleen Peterson. Cable Pollock.
Daniel Primish.
Zakir Abdul Rahman.
Amu Raj.
Stephen Hormachuelo Santos.
Annie Shoemaker.
Anika West Slazuski.
Lucas Street.
Joseph Toby Stuckey. Dane W. Van Reith Thorne.
Chinmay Salinger Upadhyay.
Sierra Wild. Ali Louise White.
Minju and Shea.
Joshua Chambers Yap.
Zining Leonardo Su.
Sophie Flea.
Additional Bachelor of Science graduates.
Thomas S. Ann. Hojun Bang. Rahul Badami. Hana Saad Bishara. Francesca Julia Bennett. Elizabeth A. Birnbaum. Anthony Botello. Jack Winry Bowen II. Connor James Bracey. Alan James Braun. Joseph Brandeman. Madeline Elizabeth Brown. Jonathan McDaniel Burberry. Maria Del Mercy Quagdon. Olivia Ray Petrie Kaplow Monroe. Kevin J. Chang. Cameron Kimball Chapman. William Isaac Chapel. Hao Yuwen Chen, Zin Chi Chen, Jeffrey Alden Chen, Ryan Joseph Clark, Justin Thomas Clayton, Nathaniel Michael Clement, Thomas R. Conaway, Jacob William Crowley, Justin Aaron Cunningham, Nathan Daniel David, Zinhe Ding, Miwai Du, Jameson Allen Dong, Angel Luis Doniego Jr., Jake K. Doherty, Uching Wan, Daniel Lyle Elliott, Gideon Olafemi Fidel, Shengwen Feng, Alexander Filbert, Andrew Chase Foreman, Simon Merrill Frazier, Casey James French, Adriana Christina Gomez Buckley, Jonathan J. Gort, Andrew Halley Guts Hall, Chandler R. Hansen, Jesse Felix Hernandez, Michael Edward Higgins, Yin Chung Ho, Sarah Francis Ho, Alexander Gold Hyde, Ryan P. Jack Kim, Dylan Patrick Jeffrey, Taylor Ian Jeffrey, Mingwei Jang, Kai Jin, Jared Reed Johnson, Mason Daniel Camp, Miles Riley Keating, Sean Tanner Kendall, Sung Hoon Kim, Dobin Kim, Gawan Kim, Harim Kim, Jinjie Kim, Daniel Michael Kirby, Adam Klingler, Megan E. Kakoris, Dirk Komernitsky, Hima Bendu Karanma, Wayne Y. Zachary L. Langford, Jin Kyung Lee, Sung Yong Lee, Kwan Wei Lee, Jonah T. LeBron, Chen Chin Lin, Noah Lin, Christian David Longker, Iana Lazina, Bo Fanhua, Kyle Philip Macalini, Mahia Colette McRory, Chihan Murdos, Yoana Alexandra Mididian, Zachary Mulally, Kenji Robert Nakamichi, Brandon David Nakata, Benin Nguyen Albant, Tal D. Ngo, John Vu Nguyen, Kavin Phung Nguyen, Aiden Thomas O'Hara, David A. Olson, April Marie Opsvig, Jonathan Palagashvili, Jeffrey Wilson Patrick, Lisa Ann Pellaren, Forrest Cadman Perry, Kyle Lawrence Pitts, Ludmila Polvoy, the first, Isabella Pollock, Sawati Watpoon Sawat, Hayden McPartland Potter, William L. Preston, the third, Taylor Allen Pruitt, Zaid Rajab, Rowanda Kani Ramos, Andrea Gray Robinson, Krishni Kasaikia, George W. Schaefer, Albert J. Wonseo, Chelsea Rivam Seidlitz, Natalie Shen, Sichi Shen, Tianyu Shi, Eric Sei Ungiun Chen, Andrew Brian Sims, Stephanie Tram Sen, Prati Ush Singh, Samuel Garrett Skullrood, Caleb Wilson Smith, Rory Smith Soifer, Daniela S. Sokratov, Avi Saval, Brandon David Spicer, Maxime Nicole St. Pierre Nelson, Eddie Ching Su, Takayuki Jason Sukigara, David Mullivahill Thompson, Mercedes Sierra Thompson, Noemi Angeli Cornell Tint, Brenda Trent, Jace Kiyoshitsu, Song Chi Tu, Anisha Pagandri, Jimmy Vovan, Chelsea Lynn Van Landigan, Rennie Andrew Wallen, Madeline Elise Walters, Xiu Yong Wang, Xu Wang, Yulong Wang, Ji or Yui Wang, Bjorn Alden Warford, Derek Ryan Lingard, Ian Douglas Walgott, Corey S. Wolf, Colin Jacob Wong, C. Tung Wu, Zachary James Basel Vutrick, Nicholas Sebastian Yokum, Matthew Koji Yonimoto, Phoenix Corbin Youngman, Jia Wiyu, Fujang Yu, Man Yuan, Michael Phillips Arimba, Davi Elliott Sar Shinas, Ziad Ali H. Zawawi, Kun Zhang, Yifan Zhu.
Congratulations to the undergraduate class of 2020.